Hi guys, my name is Ravi Prakash. Let's continue functions now. Okay, so we're starting the next question here. A bit of next concept actually we'll see through this. Okay, so A is a set here containing all the natural numbers from 1 to 9. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so we'll do various questions in this, right? So first question is, number of non-empty subsets of A. Okay, so we'll try to find out here. First question, number of non-empty subsets of A. Right. So we know the funda behind, what is the funda behind this, right? What is subset we know? Okay, so basic concept, what is subset actually? So if A is equal to all the elements from, A contains a set which contains all the elements from 1 to 9, then subset is basically A containing any part of it, right? So let's say, what is subset of A? So subset of A means set containing all 1 to 9. This is also got subset of A, right? Exactly, if A contains all the elements from 1 to 9, then 1 to 9 is also a subset of A, right? Or it could be 1, or it could be only 2 and 3, okay? Or it could be any part of it, right? It could be any part of it, 2 or 3. It could be 4, 6 and 9. So all these are what? All these are subsets of A actually, okay? So any part of A, including that whole of A is called subset of A. What is proper subset? So proper subset means this part will not be there. Okay. So proper subset means this part will not be there. Proper subset means this should be a proper subset. That means exactly if A contains all the elements from 1 to 9, that exactly 1 to 9 elements will not be a subset of A. That is inside the proper subset, right? So proper subset means any part, that means let's say 1, it could be 1. It could be 2, it could be 1, 2, 3, like that, okay, till 8, okay, but not 1 to 9, but not 1 to 9, this is not the proper subset, okay? So this is the basic meaning of subsets and proper subsets, okay? So how many non-empty subsets of A, right? So basically what is the funda actually? We know that out of this formula, we know, no? NC0 from P and C, NC0 plus NC1 plus NC2 plus NCN is equal to 2 raised to N. This we know. We studied this in P and C also, right? Now, if we have this 1, 2, 3, 4, so what we're doing here? Out of 9 elements, so how many non-empty subsets we can form of A? So out of 9 elements, I can select either 0 element or 1 element or means plus sign, or 2 elements or means plus sign, or 3 elements, till 9 elements. Okay, this is equal to what? 2 raised to 9. But what I want here is non-empty subset. So what is non-empty subset? It should not contain 0 element. So it should not contain 9C0. I should send 9C00 to this side, that becomes 9C1 plus 9C2 till 9C9. Is 9C9? Okay, 9C9. This is equal to 2 raised to n minus 1. This is the answer, right? This is the answer. 2 raised to n minus 1. Okay, so how many non-empty subsets of A? So how many subsets from A I can form? Out of 9 elements, I can choose either 0 element or 1 element or 2 or 3 till 9. That total sum is equal to how much? 2 raised to 9. But I want non-empty subset. That means subset should contain at least 1 element. That is what? So the element is 9 raised to 0, 9C0. So that is equal to 2 raised to 9 minus 1. Okay. Now, same thing if I want number of proper subsets here. Okay. Number of proper subsets of A. So how many proper subsets of A here? So proper subsets of A will be equal to, so what I want, non-empty proper subset, okay, number of non-empty proper subset, let me write this, which are non-empty. Which are non-empty, right? So what I should put here now, so I know that total, actually this is 2 raised to 9 minus 1, right? Make it 2 raised. So number of proper subsets of A which are non-empty, right? So total out of 2 raised to 9 minus 1 set, what I want is that should not contain, what is proper subset, difference between subset and proper subset, I told, that should not contain exactly same element as A. That means exactly same set as A. So if A contains a set of all the natural numbers from 1 to 9, its subset can contain a same set of natural numbers from 1 to 9. But proper subset cannot contain that exactly same set, right? That means this one more case I have to eliminate. That means which case I need to eliminate? This 9C9. I have to eliminate this 9C9 actually, right? So what is my answer? It should be like 9C1 plus 9C2 till 9C8, that is equal to 2 raised to 9, and further 9, what is 9C9? 1. So further 1, so 2 raised to 9 minus 2. This is my answer. 2 raised to 9 minus 2. This is my answer for this question. Okay, so this is the meaning of subset and proper subset, right? I hope you got it. Okay, it's a good concept. You should know this meaning of non-empty subsets, proper subset, and basically, right? All of you have told multiple times while watching functions, especially first 3-4 videos, have basic idea of permutation combination. Just watch my first 5-6 videos of permutation combination, even if you don't complete it, and then come back to functions, right? Because in functions, we'll be using those concepts of P and C. Okay, so all this we have used, because it has to be, right? How many functions I need to calculate, how many onto functions, how many into functions, how many subsets, proper subsets, right? So all these for concepts, we need the basic idea of P and C. Let's watch starting 5-6 videos of mine in P and C, and then come back to functions, complete functions, and later on you can complete your permutation combination chapter, right? Okay, now let's move on to third question in this category. So again, this A was set here. I told A is set of all elements from 1 to 9, all the natural numbers. So third question would be number of subsets of A that contains at least 2 elements, right? If I want number of subsets of A that contains at least 2 elements, at least 2 elements. So now it should be easy, right? What is the answer? You can just sense your answer. What is the answer here? So total, at least 2 means I need the values from which side? I need the value starting from 2. So what value I need actually? Right, I need from 9C2 plus 9C3 till 9C9. It's subset now. So again, this can be identical as the original set, right? So no issue now. This is equal to what? 2 raised to 9 minus 9C1 plus 9C0. 2 raised to 9 minus 9C0 plus 9C1. This is the answer for this third question. Okay, let's move to fourth question. Let's see all the varieties here. Number of subsets of A that contains 1, 2, 3. Yeah. A bit of thinking I do here. Number of subsets of A that contains 1, 2, 3 always, right? So what is the answer for this? So you can think a little bit. Okay, just pause this video, think for this. Okay, we'll continue. So number of subsets of A that contains at least that contains always 1, 2, 3 is how much? See, that basically means what? So out of 9 elements, okay, out of 9 elements, you always have this 1, 2, 3 actually, right? So now you are left with actually 6 elements, right? Your set always contains 1, 2, 3. It has to be there, right? So you can just choose, 6 elements now. Right, so to make this 9 element set, right? So you have to choose 6 elements. So out of 6 elements, you can choose 0, so it remains 1, 2, 3. Out of 6 elements, or you can choose 1, it could be 1, 2, 3, 4. Out of 6 elements, it can choose any 2. It could be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. Huh? So till out of 6, you can select any 6. And we know this, right? What is this? This is equal to 2 raised to 6. So what is the answer? Answer for this question is 64. So 64 is the answer for this question. Yeah, I hope it is clear. Right. Same way, answer will remain same if I put something like this. Let's say I move to question 5 here. And I put number of subsets of A that does not contain. Okay. That does not contain six, seven, eight. So what is my answer? My answer will remain same, because if it doesn't contain 6, 7, 8, still what I need to do? I need to always choose 6 element, right? So still what I need to do here? I need to always choose any 6 elements. So choosing 6 elements means either 0 or 1 or 2 or till 6. Okay. So 2 raised to 6 is equal to 64. Okay. So it is not non-empty subset, right? Non-empty subset means it has to contain at least one element, right? But if it is if it is normal subset, so a subset means if A is containing all the natural numbers from 1 to 9, so its one subset can be empty also, and its one subset can be elements containing from 1 to 9 also, right? So both these are subsets of A, okay? So I hope this concept is clear, right? So all of this counting and all from this P and C part, right? This should be clear to all. Okay. Now let me move to a new concept, a bit of questions which are asked in recent or in last 5-6 years in CAT, right? So they ask simple questions on functions, just logical for thinking, right? They don't want anything very exclusive to be functions, right? As I've seen the pattern actually. Yet I'll do all the concepts, right? But the kind of questions we should focus is basically kind of putting values and putting your thinking cap on, those kind of questions, right? So for example, let's do few such questions also, and then we'll generalize it also. Okay, so you don't need to worry, we'll cover everything in functions, right? Once we started functions, we'll cover everything in function, right? Okay, so let's say a different variety of different variety of question here. So question is basically 1 by x fx minus 3 of f 1 by x is equal to 3 by 2. Okay, so this is a question here, right? Now just think, if I need to calculate in this here, x is not equal to 0, and what is the value of f3 I need to calculate? Okay, so as such, you don't need any functions kind of concept in this, right? You can simply directly think of this funda. Okay, so what is the value? So see, what value I should put here? To understand this, what value I should put here? We have, it's like, you can treat like we have actually three variables here. Okay, so if we have two variables here, fx and f of 1 by x, and then we need value of f3 actually, right? So only f3 I need, huh? I can't put anything else, but we have here fx as well as f of 1 by x. So what you can actually think here is, okay, so let's say I put x is equal to 3. So if I put x is equal to 3, what I'll get here? 1 by 3 f of 3 minus 3 f of 1 by 3 is equal to 3 by 2. Let me call it equation 1. Okay? Let me call it equation 1. Now, I have to find the value of f3 only, right? So you have to find the value of f3 here. So what you can put here? Second value. So that because already we have two variables. Treat like simple equation. We have two variables here. F3 and f of 1 by 3. Right. So I should not get anything extra from this. So what I should put? Put your common sense. So I should put basically x equal to 1 by 3 I should put. So now the equation becomes 3 f of 1 by 3 minus three f of 3 is equal to 3 by 2. This is my equation 2 actually, right? And we can solve these two equations to get the value of f3, correct? So you can simply, what we can do here, simply add this. So I think minus 3 f1 by 3 plus 3 f1 by 3 will get cancelled. These two will get cancelled. So what I'll get here? 1 by 3 f3 minus 3 f3. So I get minus 1 by 3. So I get minus, it's like 1 by 3x minus 3x. Okay, so it's same thing, yeah. So 1 by 3 minus 3, I'll get minus 8. Just wait. Yeah, minus 8 by 3 f of 3. And it is added here. So this part will be how much? 3 by 2 plus 3 is equal to 3. Right. So what is my f3? My f3 will be equal to what? Minus 9 upon 8. This should be the answer. Got it? Right. So as simple as funda, right? So this should be, we should know such kind of questions actually also. Okay. They ask this kind of questions in CAT. Okay. And in other exams also. Just pure logic, nothing else. Okay. Yeah. Let's see one more question also of this kind. Let's say, f of x plus 2 f of 1 by x is equal to 2x. What is the value of f of 1 by 4? This is a question here. You can just pause this video and try for 2-3 minutes. You can solve this question actually. Okay. So what I'll do here, now you got the logic. First time I'll put x is equal to 1 by 4. So what I'll get here? Let's say f of 1 by 4 plus 2 f of 4 is equal to 1 by 2. Correct? This is my equation 1. And I want to stick with f of 1 by 4 and f of 4. So what I should put next value of x? I should put x equal to 4 then, right? Because it is x and 1 by x, so 4 and 1 by 4. If I put x equal to 4, what I get here? F of 4 plus twice of f of 1 by 4 is equal to 8. This is my equation 2. And I can solve these two equations to get the value of f of 1 by 4. Okay, so what I should do here? Just I think we can find the value of f of 1 by 4. So you can just eliminate this f of 4 actually. So multiply this equation by 2 and then subtract. This would work, right? So what is this? So 2 of f by 4, 2 of f4 and 2 f4 will get cancelled. Okay. So it's like f of 1 by 4 plus twice of f of 1 by 4. Huh. So what answer will get? 2 and this 1. So I'll get 30 f of 4 should be equal to f of 1 by 4 should be equal to 31 by 6, right? Yeah, f of 1 by 4 should be equal to 31 by 6. That is 5.167 around. This should be the answer. Okay, so I hope it is clear, this kind of question. Okay, so in next video, we'll continue with the functions. Thank you for watching.